Now we're going to study about voluntary and involuntary muscles. Now, what is the meaning of voluntary? Voluntary means where you can move about your muscles on your will. It all depends on your will. So just now, if you're moving a hand, that means you are moving the muscles of the hand, right? So that is on your wish. You're moving, you're sitting, standing, you're running, you're jumping. Okay, is all on your wish. So that becomes voluntary muscles. These muscles move on your wish. Whereas involuntary muscles don't, even if you say jump, sit, run, walk, they will not listen to you. Okay, so these are involuntary muscles. Now these involuntary muscles usually, not usually, but they are found in the inner part of your body, which wherein you cannot, you don't have a choice to move them, right? So let's see once again, what are voluntary muscles? Muscles that are under your control, under your conscious control, like smiling, turning a page in a book, working with your hands, walking, eating, running, etc. All depend on your will. So that becomes voluntary muscles, okay? Then involuntary, which are not in your control, are involuntary. Now I just showed you so many organs just now, so many organ systems we have just seen. So all these organs are working inside of your body. You can't say stomach, now you stop working, you rest. A heart, you're tired of beating, so just take some rest. Nothing can be done, isn't it? So they, you cannot control them. Okay, so these are involuntary muscles. They will work for you till you are alive. Isn't it? They will work for you till you are alive. So these involuntary muscles bring about so many movements within your body. Within your body. Say, for example, lungs, hearts, stomach, intestines, and so on. Then, here we study the different types of muscles. So we have three different types of muscles: skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. So in the next picture, you will see where these muscles are found. So three different types of muscles are found in the body. All over your body is the skeletal muscle. The muscles inside your body, okay, which helps the organs to work, are the smooth muscles, and the heart alone is made up of cardiac muscle. So cardiac muscle is present only in the heart. Got it? So we'll just see in detail about these three. First is the skeletal muscle. Two ends of each of these muscles are attached to two different bones. Okay, so if you look, have a closer look at these muscles, you will find, see, for example, this muscle that I'm pointing out. See, one end is attached to this side, the other end is attached to this side. Similarly, the muscle over here on the shoulder, one end over here, the other end over here. Okay, so they are attached to two different bones. And movements of these muscles are voluntary, as I told you. Okay, then they hold the bones of the skeleton together and give shape to our body. So where are these muscles found? Obviously all around our body, okay, in the hands and in the legs. You can move them. These muscles can be moved according to your wish. So they are voluntary muscles. Skeletal muscles are voluntary muscles. They can move on your wish. Next is the smooth muscle. The smooth muscle, they form the internal organs. Okay, the stomach over here. See this, these are the muscles of the stomach as shown in this picture. Then this is your blood vessel. Okay, so these are the smooth muscles. See, surrounding the blood vessels, the smooth muscle, as you can see over here. Okay, so their movement is involuntary and slow. Okay, the muscles which are present in the intestines and in the organs of your body, internal organs, these except heart, okay, except heart, all the other organs are smooth muscles. they are involuntary. They are not in your control. Fine. Then the next is the cardiac muscle. As I told you, the cardiac muscle is present in and only your heart. Okay, so you can see over here the heart, and you can see the cut section of the heart and see how it looks from within. Okay, there are four chambers in your heart. We will study about it later on, but not in our syllabus, of course, maybe when you go to higher classes. So these are the auricles and ventricles that you can see inside the heart. Blood comes over here for purification. Okay, from heart goes, it goes to the lungs, and from the lungs it absorbs oxygen or gives out carbon dioxide and so on. Okay, heart is an organ of circulatory system. Now children, you can see mouth watering dishes over here. Okay, now what have I to say over here is all the muscles of our body must be strong and efficient. So if you want your muscles to be strong and efficient, for that you should have a proper balanced diet. Okay, the diet must include, now we have done so many things about that. The diet must include all the required carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, fats in a sufficient quantity. Okay, that is helpful for your body, for the growth of your body, and for the repair and wear and tear of your body. But sometimes we see this picture when the food is not liked by you, isn't it? You don't like to eat vegetables, you don't like to eat fruits. So when they come in front of you, you start wondering, what do I do with this now? Isn't it? And these are the different, you make such faces. Then mama gives you vegetables and fruits to eat. But mind you children, they are very, very efficient, very, very useful for your growth. Okay. As you can see in this picture, fruits and vegetables will make you strong. Right. Then what can you see over here? You can see exercises being done. Now, do you think it is important? It is necessary? Of course, yes. Very much important to keep your muscles in shape and in control, of course, isn't it? Okay, so exercise, regular exercise should form your should be the part of your regular, your day-to-day chores. Whatever you've been doing, you should find time for exercise. Regular exercise will keep your muscles strong and healthy. Besides that, it will keep you in good shape. Who doesn't like to be in good shape, isn't it? We all love to be in good shape. And sometimes when we go out of shape, we don't like it, isn't it? Then we have to diet, then we have to join the gym and so on. Okay, you must be seeing people around doing all this, all these activities. Okay, so if you eat healthy food and you exercise regularly, definitely you will be in good shape with strong muscles. Then besides this, children, how you the way you sit. Now just now how you're sitting, just have a close look at yourself, how you're sitting for this class. Some of you are lying down on the bed. Some of you are sitting on the chair. I don't know how you are sitting. Okay. But good and bad posture also matters when it comes to muscles. Okay. And if you don't follow good and good posture, then definitely your muscles start giving you trouble. And you have seen this when you sit in, when you sit on a sofa, you know, just lie down sluggishly here and there. Okay, when you get up, sometimes your back starts paining, your shoulders start paining. Okay, it is all because you don't follow good posture. Okay, now these are only two examples that I've given you, but in many other ways of life you should be following good posture while sitting down or do walking and so on. And the next is, of course, exercise is very important. So during exercise, movement of the heart becomes more rapid. Breathing also becomes faster, you must have. Okay, you must have noticed it, isn't it? When you run for some time, you start, the heartbeats increase, and you also, I mean, you start breathing a little faster. Okay, okay. So enduring a sufficient supply of oxygen and nutrients to various parts of the body. So children, we will stop over here. This is the end with the muscular system.